One is this AI thing, right? Is AI going to create more jobs or take away more jobs or both? And how and what should we do as IT people that, okay, this AI hype is happening. Whether it is hype or not is another question, but what are your thoughts?
So two, three things before I answer the question. One, everything is a hype and everything is not a hype. There is some truth always in some new method. If you look at the recorded history, industrial history, at least of 200, 250 years and all, every few years, there is something that changed the world.
Correct.
Some of those things actually changed the world. Some of those things didn't change the world to the extent that people thought they will, right? In our own last 25, 30 years, whatever combined, you know, experience we have, you would have seen several such things that were ready to change the world. Next thing we would know that, you know, 2026, 1st of January, we'll all be on Mars. Those kind of predictions were made, mostly not true, but some of it got true. That is point one. So there is some level of hype always because, see, somebody is selling this. They need to create that hype.
Correct.
Without hype or without some fear psychosis, who's going to buy this? Right? So there is some need for. So please, everybody take it with some little bit of a pinch of salt that this needs to be sold. Anything that needs to be sold, some hype has to be created for that. Right?
Correct.
So including, you know, a television web series, some hype has to be created for it to be shown. So this is much bigger than that. Two, something Bill Gates has said several years ago that, you know, we underestimate what we can achieve in 10 years and overestimate what we can achieve in 1 year. Same thing applies to AI. Your life is not going to change tomorrow, but it will change definitely in 1 year, 2 year, 3 years time, significantly. Third, now coming to actual, the what is AI going to be able to do? I think we have enough evidence, Anand, that it is going to significantly change things. For the first time in the last 10, 20 years, we have something which is growing so rapidly, use cases are growing so rapidly that there will be a significant shift. One shift I can share directly here, and this is from an IT context, since many of your audience members are from IT. See, the flirtation with Gen AI and ChatGPT and those kind of tools.
So what I was saying while you were away is that sooner or later, AI element or that technology, automation, whatever you want to call it, that element is going to be there in all jobs. It is just that we need to figure out how does it impact ours and how or what do we need to learn in the process, right?
Yeah, so that is where, Anand, I was beginning to give an example when I realized that I was offline. So I spoke about this over a large history, industrial history, there are many such changes and this is one such change, but this is significant. Two, the Bill Gates comment that I made. Three, I was saying that there, some things are very real now. The fascination with GPT and Gen AI and all this will slowly fade because it will become part of what we do. So there will be no separate activity around this. And it will, of course, keep getting better. Today, when you chat with the GPT environment, you will see that the quality is far, far better than maybe 6 months ago or 1 year ago or only that kind of thing. But one thing that is already changing a lot of jobs is agentic AI.
Correct.
So the combination of all this ChatGPT and generative AI and the ability to conduct tasks and all, if agents are able to, bots or new words agents, agents are able to decide what is the course of action and perform that action on your behalf, what happens to the BPO industry?
Yeah.
Extremely difficult question to answer.
Correct.
Now, let me take you 10 years ago. For many banks, you had to call up a call center to change your address. Simple, simple example I'm giving you. Or to ask for a statement.
Correct.
Then the banks moved to the statement being available online and address you can change online with giving some authentication with either a two-factor or your Aadhaar card or something. You can change your address on your own. No need to call somebody. Photocopy bhi leke jane ka, you know, none of that is, for the last 10 years, you have not seen, right? Maybe 5-7 years. Same shift will happen to your simple tasks being performed by an agent. So you call up a, you know, let's say a bank or an insurance thing and file a claim. The agent itself will ask you those 5 questions and record a claim and be able to decide that whether your claim sounds genuine, the photograph that you've sent of your car crash, all that will be able to decide. So what is the need for 4 people who were earlier doing that? And in this, so those who are from banking operations will realize that there is something called segregation of duties. So a person who is agreeing on the loan doesn't actually draw down the loan, right? So that the corruption angle can be minimized or eliminated. When agentic AI is doing this, You don't even need four people. The same person can decide on the loan, the same person can draw the loan, the same person can transfer the money and everything, or same agent. So this is going to be very, very significant. Anybody who's planning a career in BPO and BPS services, my expectation is that in the next 1 to 3 years, this will have a huge load. And India is going to be a very, very big part of this whole thing, because we will partly suffer, first be a victim. Then if we figure it out, we might be a victor, because a lot of our young population, English speaking population, get jobs in BPS. If a US based company, insurance company, has to give their work to some Indian based BPO, they no longer have to do that. They can sit in the US. The bot can also be in the US. The customer is anyway in the US. No need for the bot to be in India.
Correct.
Right. So the BPO companies will have to change their game significantly and offer these services, even the bot services, at a fraction. So if a bot is going to cost $40,000, $50,000 a year, will the Indian BPO company offer it at $10,000?
Right.
So yeah, that game is a huge game. We don't know. So youngsters looking for a job in BPO and all, it's going to be a struggle. So this change is already happening.
Yeah.
But many of these changes have happened over the last 50 years. The larger part of your question, Anand, was that whether this will have significant impact on jobs like yours and mine. Of course, yes, because we are also managing the people who are going to get eliminated. So at some point, we will get eliminated, because if one manager is needed for 20 people, and those 20, there are such 100 teams of 20 each, 100 teams become 50, which means those 20 managers are also not needed, right? So there will be significant impact, and you and I can't today predict what, but I would strongly recommend to your viewers who are live and will watch later to not take this lightly at all. This is going to really, really, really change everything. It is already changing, and maybe we don't even know how it will change.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. Thank you. Thank you for that, Anshuman. So for those who are watching us live, there are, I think, around 80 plus people watching us live. I want to share one thing, right? You must be wondering why you are not able to add your questions in the live chat. So one reason is because the chat is member only at this moment. And I would like to welcome KVN Rao, who joined us as a member just now. So welcome, KVN Rao. There are a lot of people who are members of this channel. So if you are a member, you can definitely put your question. So I would like to take, Anshuman, this question from KVN Rao. It actually has two parts to the question. One is, which sectors would benefit more from AI? That's the first question. If I have to answer this question, I would say a lot of sectors would benefit from AI, starting from, let's say, healthcare and pharma, right? Because there can be a lot of AI-driven diagnostics, drug discovery, personalized medicine, and whatnot. But Anshuman, your thoughts on which industries or sectors would benefit from AI?
So at a low level, Anand, any sector that has repetitive tasks will benefit. Now, you can argue that the benefit might be for the sector, but will be a problem for the employees. Yes. So a company might benefit, industry might benefit, but the employees might suffer, because they will probably be out of a job. So you see it with the way you want to see it. But since the question is from an industry point of view, I am answering it from an industry point of view. Any tasks that are repetitive in nature or simple routine tasks, they will definitely get automated through what was started by RPA will probably be finished by AI or agentic AI, like I mentioned, right? So this is a combination of many technologies, which will now make these things possible. So repetitive tasks, definitely. Then the second will be any kind of task where a lot of assimilation is required, coordination and, you know, aggregation assimilation is required, like education. So somebody has to read a lot of papers and decide on something. Those things will become far, far more easier. Now, is this an industry? Maybe not. But is this good? Maybe not. But this is definitely going to happen. People will become subscriber to a lot of these companies who will provide summarized information on their field of expertise. Then is the holy trinity, like I call, medicine or healthcare, you can say, education and agriculture. These three areas, I always say that any technology that impacts any of these three, or maybe two or three, or all these three, is really beneficial to mankind. So we can definitely see a lot of application of AI models in agriculture, because predicting rainfall, monsoon, earthquake, and all these things might become easier. For medicine, you already said that a lot of models are being in, put in place because, see, the knowledge might not be new, but the ability to churn a lot of data with context. Data churning was possible 5 years ago, but data is being churned with context now. That is new, right? So that might happen. I often quote this example. There is a research in the US some years ago, and it is still being developed, that looking at the parameters of women who are coming for checkups, this model was able to predict some cases where they were likely to have breast cancer. No. And they actually did. So the model was right. The doctors were wrong in this case. The doctors could not see any sign. And the model was able to see those signs because the model was able to take a lot of information which doctors could not at that short note. So if this kind of prediction starts happening, if I can know 10 years in advance of a potential disease that I can go through, it will be far more. See, today, for example, everybody knows that smoking will cause something down the line. Everybody knows that if you drink too much, it will cause this. Everybody knows that if you don't exercise enough. But these are very simple things, you know. So everybody, there is no fear in this anymore.
Correct.
But if there's a custom analysis of my data, my gene sequence, my lifestyle, and predicts that in 5 to 7 years, I will go through this disease or this life-threatening situation, I am going to get really shit scared. You know, I will do something about it. Because it is now me. It is not about that smoking is injurious to health. It is injurious to health of the entire population, right? So it doesn't do anything to me, right?
Correct.
So those use cases are significant. And I certainly think, to answer Mr. Kavian Rao's question, that at the base level, it will impact industries that are repetitive, then which are aggregating things. And at a higher level, it will impact medicine, education, and healthcare. Agriculture.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Anshuman, for that. So I hope, Kavian, you got a pretty detailed response there. My 2 cents on this one is the use cases will be there in almost all sectors. For example, in supply chain and logistics, AI-driven route optimization, demand forecasting, that's already happening. Then there's cybersecurity, where you have AI-powered threat detection and response, right? In legal and compliance also, now there is so much of analysis and legal research happening on a lot of areas, right? So document review, like what Anshuman said, in education, it applies in legal compliance as well. So there is so much happening. You will have impact in telecommunication, where you will have AI powered, let's say, network optimization or customer service automation. In energy and utility, you will have smart grids. I think that's already happening for energy demand forecasting and all of that. So it's everywhere. It is just a matter of time, right? So that's the answer to the first part. There is one more question, which I think KV and Rao asked, which is, how will AI impact in B2B space? Okay, so in B2B space, my initial thoughts are that, like the other spaces that we talked about, it would be, for example, let's say sales and marketing, right? Where you will have AI-driven segmentation and lead scoring. So you have a lot of leads. You need to score those leads or segment them. Then you can have personalized email-driven content marketing automation-based campaigns. Okay. So that's your sales and marketing. But you will also have impacts on operations, workforce management, customer support, customer success, and all of those. So B2B is also going to get impacted largely by AI. But those are like my initial thoughts on that one. Anything that comes to your mind, Anshuman, on B2B?
Not specifically, apart from very clever use cases of predicting, like you said, conversion, right? So I often say that, see, we have to be very mindful that what we call AI is one element of AI. True AI is if the software or the app can predict or can figure out what is the color, what is the emotion, what is the depth through means. So that will be true AI, right? So today the camera knows that I'm wearing a whatever, that light green shirt, you are wearing a pink red kind of a shirt. But it doesn't really know that it is red.
Correct.
It just knows it is a color. So what if tomorrow these things can be recognized? You know, that will be even next level of AI. So we can see each other in two dimensions. Can we tomorrow see each other in three dimensions? So those advances will take this even further in B2B. But today's B2B will be mostly about in making clever decisions about situations like conversions, lead, like you said, or like, you know, for years, Asian Paints had been doing brilliant work on replenishing the stock at the retailers. So they know very clearly that what is getting out and are able to replenish that stock. Now, those things need not be AI, but you can build some AI models into that. Need not be AI, but it's close to that. So those examples will happen in B2B, certainly. And that will bring down cost as well. My favorite example these days is that if government, any government, and I don't want to make it a political point of view, but if we can help farmers grow what is right for that soil and for that environment without additional pressure on water and electricity, that will be a huge win, huge, huge win. Now, some countries are trying that, but they are smaller countries, large country like India. If we can convert agriculture into need-based agriculture for that region, that will be awesome. Today, wheat is grown in Punjab but sold in other, or rice is grown in Punjab but sold in Orissa. Doesn't make sense. So if these models can convert that, that will be awesome. But then I think that is beyond the scope of KVN's question.
Yeah, but a very valid point there. So I think KVN, you got a lot of thoughts there. I believe, I mean, the last thing which comes to my mind is where you have product development happening in IT, where you can use AI to assist on the design and prototyping. Because if that can happen, a lot of AI-driven software development, code generation, and all those things will happen. A lot of people are scared about this. It's a little far. I mean, not that far, but yes, definitely happening, right? So I think that is one more space to look out for. But thank you, Anshuman, for sharing your views on this. That was KVN's question from the member chat here.